I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week comes from Jason Wisser, who wants to know, what are these reddish blobs on the undersides of the leaves of his oak tree? Well, Jason, these blobs look pretty scary, especially with that stark red color. But truly, they're nothing to worry too much about. The blobs are the early stages of gall formation, tumor-like growths created by the tree in response to insect activity. We consulted AgriLife Extension entomologist Wizzy Brown, who concludes that these are the result of gall midge larvae. The reason I say that they're not worth worrying about is that they don't do any long-term damage to the tree, even if you have a heavy infestation. The leaves may be misshapen a bit this season and may not perform photosynthesis at 100% efficiency, but the tree barely notices. There are many insects that cause trees to make galls to protect and serve as a food source for their growing larvae, and some years see heavier infestations of these pests than others. But the tree will drop these leaves at the end of the season later this year, and most likely next year, these same insects will be less populous. In any event, even if we wanted to treat for them, the natural design of the gall prevents chemicals from penetrating through to do any damage to the growing insect inside. Our plant this week is warm weather annual zinnia, of which there are a multitude of species, varieties, and cultivars to choose. Although transplant seedlings are easy to find in the spring, usually sold in six packs or flats of 18 to 24 plants, nurseries can only carry so many choices. So if you shop early for seeds and start them yourself, either in flats indoors or directly in the garden, you'll have many more colors, shapes, and sizes available to try. I can't think of a single zinnia that wouldn't perform well in virtually any garden as long as temperatures are warm enough when you plant them. These cheery flowers come in virtually every color, love the heat, and require full sun for most of the day in order to grow and flower properly. They aren't too picky about soil type and don't need much water, but make sure to water them regularly during dry spells. Zinnias are great for pollinators of all kinds and will flower more prolifically if you take a little time to deadhead spent blooms. Viewer Tanya Joseph sent along pictures of butterflies on her zinnias last summer. And it's not too late to plant fall blooming plants for pollinators. Robert Villarreal celebrates fall every year with yellow flowers from perennial native Copper Canyon Daisy, which has fragrant leaves, and Mexican Mint Marigold. You can also snip the leaves for a taste of tarragon in your recipes. Depending on your microclimate, it's an annual or perennial that returns after top dieback in winter. We'd love to hear from you, so head on over to KRLU.org/CTG to send us your questions, pictures, and video.